This lesson is part two of a two-part lesson in which we will discuss adding labels to incident maps. In this part, we will discuss the three most common methods of adding labels to incident maps: dynamic labeling, the National Incident Feature Service label point, and annotation. The objective of this lesson is to review standards and techniques for labeling incident features on incident map products. Students who complete part two of this lesson will be able to identify the primary techniques for adding text labels to incident maps. Those include dynamic labeling, the National Incident Feature Service label point layer, and annotation. And students will be able to discuss the pros and cons of each method. The first technique we will discuss is dynamic labeling. Dynamic labeling is used primarily for labeling incident point features like drop points and helispots, as well as labeling non-incident features such as roads and fire history. When using dynamic labeling, map labels are displayed dynamically, meaning they will not need to be added or removed each time a feature is added or removed. Labeling is stored as a property of a layer within a map layout. The font size is set within the layer's properties and remains the same on a map layout even as the map scale is adjusted. Individual feature labels cannot be changed or manipulated. The National Incident Feature Service, or NIFS, label point feature class is used primarily to label assignments like division branches on incident maps. Because the label point feature class is part of the NIFS, label points will appear in both ArcGIS Pro map layouts that include the label point features and web maps that contain the National Incident Feature Service. The label point is an unsymbolized point feature that is labeled dynamically with four unique feature classes. These include branch or zone, division, other small, and other large. Because it is part of the NIFS, edits made and synced to the label point by a GISS should propagate to any incident maps that contain the label point feature from the Master Incident Geo Database, as well as online incident maps accessed through field maps and web browsers. Annotation has been typically used to label assignments like divisions and branches. It can be especially useful on complex, multi-page map series layouts where more than one assignment label may be necessary to clearly label an assignment area. Annotation is based on a reference scale, meaning the font size is tied to that reference scale and will not change when the map scale changes in a layout. Annotation is stored as a geodatabase feature class. Annotation features are tied to geospatial locations and will stay at the location they are placed in until moved by the editor. Each annotation text feature can be manipulated separately. Prior to the introduction of the NIFS label point feature class, divisions and branches were often labeled using annotation. Within ArcGIS Pro, a layer's basic labeling properties can be accessed from the label ribbon within the feature layer section. Complete label properties for a layer can be accessed from the labeling properties pane by right-clicking the feature in the context pane and selecting label properties. The label ribbon gives the user the ability to update basic properties of a selected layer's label. The labeling properties pane, on the other hand, gives the user the ability to update and alter the full suite of labeling options for a feature's label. There are numerous settings that can be adjusted to ensure map labels display properly. Applying label weights, label priority rankings, and modifying label offset properties can help ensure that point labels don't obscure or interfere with important map features. The primary advantage of using labeling is that it is pre-configured in the Pro Project Template Map and therefore easy to use and manage. Properly configured labels will simply appear, disappear, and reposition as map features are added or updated, or the map layout is adjusted. This is particularly beneficial for a multi-page map series, such as a multi-page IAP map. In certain situations, labels may not appear or may never be placed appropriately. This typically happens in areas where there are clusters of features that require labels. Labeling features in these situations may require a different approach, such as using forcing labels to draw or using annotation. Label point features within the NIFS can be constructed and placed using Create Features window and standard editing tools within ArcGIS Pro. In that way, it is somewhat like Annotation feature class. Unlike the Annotation feature class, however, the NIFS label point can sync with the National Incident Feature Service and is part of the Master Incident Geo database. In many cases, the NIFS label point feature class is now being used as a substitute for the simple assignment annotation feature classes that were once commonplace on incident maps. Well-placed label point assignment features can be used by multiple users across multiple map layouts. Because the label points are labeled using dynamic labeling, certain adjustments can be made to the label point labeling properties, such as symbol size and offset position, that can allow for some map-by-map adjustment of label point features. The NIFS label point is a pre-configured part of the National Incident Feature Service and is built into the Pro Project template distributed with the GeoOps folder structure template. Because it is part of the NIFS, it will sync to and provide labels in web, mobile, and browser maps. It can be used like simple annotation feature classes for labeling assignments on incident maps. And if need be, it is a great source for creating an assignment annotation feature class. While some map-by-map customization of the label point is possible through the labeling properties, position edits made to label point features will propagate to all other incident maps using the label point. An annotation feature class can be created in a file geo database using the Convert Labels to Annotation option from the context menu of a labeled layer within a map layout, or by simply creating a new annotation feature class within the annotation geo database. The NIFS label point layer will almost always be the best source for creating new assignment annotation feature classes. Annotation feature classes should be stored in the annotation geo database that's distributed with the GeoOps incident folder structure template. Both the annotation geo database and the feature classes therein should be named according to GeoOps naming standards. Once created and populated, an annotation feature class with a specified reference scale can be generally used on the incident maps and products laid out on the same map scale. Creating assignment labels for multi-page map series layouts can be challenging, especially in situations where index pages span multiple assignments or split assignment areas. In these cases, an attribute such as page name can be added to an annotation feature class, and single annotation features can be set up to display or not on certain map series pages using map series page filter set on the Page Query tab of the Annotation Layer Properties. In addition to reusability, the primary advantage of geodatabase annotation is the high level of control it affords users in the placement of their map labels. Users pick exactly where annotations go, and the annotations do not move as the layout is adjusted. Annotation is also especially useful in situations where a complex multi-page map series layout is being used. Annotation feature classes must be managed separately from and in addition to other map features. Annotation text will not appear or adjust when other incident features are updated or adjusted. Let's review. After completing this lesson, students should be able to identify the three primary methods for adding label text to maps: dynamic labeling, the NIFS label point, and annotation, and discuss the pros and cons of each technique.